When we return, the men will take the ice. The leader, current world champion Alexei Yagudin, will be holding off the challenge of Todd Eldridge. Will Todd go for it all with a quad attempt? And will the hometown favorite Takeshi Honda overtake the veterans Yagudin and Eldridge? We'll find out soon. Welcome you back to the Pearl Vision Japan Open. We're at the Yoyogi National Stadium in Tokyo, Japan. Hello, everybody. I'm Tracy Wilson, joined by Rosalind Sumners and Peter Carruthers, and the men are on the ice warming up. Todd Eldridge of the United States has won the first two open competitions. Peter, he is sitting, though, in third place after the short program.
Well, for Todd Eldridge, he knows that in third place, he certainly can't hold back. Anybody that's in the top three controls their own destiny, so if he turns in a good performance and wins the interpretive free, well, guess what? He wins the competition.
Will he try his quad here?
I tell you, I was talking to him earlier, and he said, yeah, I think I'm going to try it. But, you know, it's always a skater's decision to get out there on the warm-up and say, you know, I don't feel like trying the quad. Or maybe if he's feeling really good, he will do it. So that remains to be seen.
He will be up against the current world champion, Alexei Yagudin, who's sitting in first place after the short program.
Well, for Alexei Yagudin, he was not able to do his quad. In fact, he's in a slump. He says he lost it, and so therefore he did not do it in the short program, but he skated well enough to win the short program. And it's interesting what he says about the interpretive free program. He says that these competitions bring the skaters together. The pros have something to offer, and the Olympic eligibles have something to offer, and it elevates the sport for that reason.
An Olympic eligible skater who has been performing beautifully here in practice and in the short program, Rosalind, Takeshi Honda of Japan.
Well, Takeshi keeps getting stronger and skating with more confidence. He's not only physically stronger, he's artistically stronger. He's been working with Leanne Miller, who's bringing out a lot of his personality. He's changed coaches. He's working with Doug Lee, who is used to coach Elvis Stoiko. He's got a lot of confidence in him, and they really have fun training together. He's brought a light side out of Takeshi. It's not all just grueling, and you're really seeing that in Takeshi's personality.
We certainly saw the benefits of Takeshi's new training regimen in the short program. It was a terrific performance. Let's take a Zenical look back. You can hear the audience now cheering one of their own. Here is a Japanese national champion. He was sixth at the Worlds in 1999, and many people think he will be on the podium this year, year 2000. Here is Takeshi Honda.
Trace, Roz, if he can keep his nerves in check, he is a wonderful skater, a great athlete. He has it all, but he's got to handle the pressure.
Well, his first element is the quad, and he actually landed the first time ever in the short program recently at the Japanese Nationals. Skating that I said is so much improved.
off a spread eagle right up into a double axel. Ah. Hard to do because you have to turn your hips in a different direction to get up into the air. Talk about choreography with musical effectiveness. Excellent.
Well, and that's Leanne Miller, who's worked with him for the past 3 years. And again, when you stick with somebody long enough, you really start to see the results. I'm so impressed. Strong footwork, very complicated. Wow. 18 years of age. National champion from Japan, Takeshi Honda.
18 years old, master of the quad, and the master of great choreography and style.
And he's just gone from a young teenage boy on the ice to really a man with so much command. So great to see you.
Takeshi warming up now for the men's interpretive free program. We'll have Takeshi, Todd, and Alexei when we come back.
We welcome you back to Tokyo, Japan. Let's take a look now at the starting order of the men's interpretive free skate. Philippe Candeloro, who finished fifth in the short program, will start things off, followed by Alexei Romanov of Russia. Takeshi Honda, who was second in the short program, will skate third. Todd Eldridge of the United States skates fourth. And Alexei Yagudin, the leader after the short program, will skate fifth. And once again, with the men's interpretive free program, Peter, the rules are quite relaxed.
And what they've done with the rules is restricted these athletes from doing all these big jumps. As a matter of fact, a maximum of 4 triples or more rotations can be done, and 1 jump combination is permitted. No spin restrictions. Now, you get a penalty for each excessive element.
One other rule to note is a music rule. These programs must be 3.5 to 4 minutes in length. If they are not, they will be deducted quite severely by the judges. On the ice now, a skater who has a tremendous following here in Japan. He competed here at the NHK Trophy in 92, 93, 94. Won an Olympic bronze medal here in 98, and he says he comes back year after year because this audience truly does love him. Here is Philippe Candeloro of France. And in this routine, he skates to Braveheart. Philippe has planned an interesting start to his program. His music is 5:01, and skaters are allowed to skate for 3.5 to 4 minutes. So Philippe has chosen to stand for 45 seconds, otherwise he will be severely deducted. As it is, he will still be 16 seconds over, so he will be deducted 0.2.
On each mark.
On each mark, but he said he couldn't cut any more out because it would totally ruin the program. So the judges will start the clock the minute Philippe moves.
Thank you. give all of this costume a triple lunge. Falling off the center axis, tilting in the air, caused a failed landing.
Character-driven music is Philippe's style. Using props really enhance this piece of music, again, telling the story of Braveheart.
Short of rotation on the triple loop, but the character's there, but the jumps on.
Olivia are actually expecting a baby in April, so he's taking his life to the next step. Whole new responsibility. I find, Peter, the props, yes, enhance the program, but right there he turned a triple sow into a double sow, holding a stick. Sometimes the props can be distracting. Don't forget, this long program, interpretive program, is also about technique, and you still have to do the jumps. Wow, what a rush of people coming to the boards to throw flowers. That's incredible. As you look into the crowd, you see the teenagers rushing down with hands full of flowers.
Here's the knee spin that he has made famous. It's really remarkable. And the backflip, also a real showstopper. But we have not seen a reaction like this in Japan with anyone.
We will be back with the marks for Philippe Candeloro of France after this. We welcome you back to the Yoyogi National Stadium, where the ice is littered with flowers for Philippe Candeloro. You can see the women continue to throw flowers at him as he waits in the kiss and cry area for his marks. It is going to be some time, Peter, while they're picking up these flowers off the ice. And skater next up, Alexei Armanov of Russia, is kind of warming up through the flowers.
Well, I'll tell you something. He really is a big personality in the sport of men's figure skating, certainly in Japan. And he creates that with the unusual characters and the persona that he puts on the ice.
What's interesting about Philippe was in the early 90s, he was known as a jumper that did little between his jumps. And then he developed all these great character programs, which has earned him many fans worldwide, especially here in Japan. And now the first set of marks for Philippe, 4.9 to 5.0.
Well, I mean, the music deductions are all there, up to 0.2 off of each mark for the violation there.
I also think the program, yes, it had the story of Braveheart, but there was a lot of, you know, technical sloppiness within the program that can also bring this mark down. But the second set of marks do go up. These for presentation, 5.4s and one 5.6. Well, they have cleared all the flowers off the ice, and so the second competitor in the men's event, the 1994 Olympic champion from Russia, here is Alexei Ermanov.
Struggled a little in the short program on this jump, the triple axel, but boy, not there.
Beautiful.
Look at the flow of the landing on the way out. Really controlled, nice edge.
Obviously a completely different style than Philippe Cantelaro. Very crisp, very sharp. Nice triple flip. About the contrast between Philippe Cantelaro and Alexei Ermanov, and where Philippe has always won over the audiences, Alexei has not been able to connect with his audiences outside of Russia. He's been much more popular with the judges.
Well, I don't think he really chooses music that is audience friendly. It's not music that necessarily brings you in. But now as a professional, that's something that will just be enhanced with time.
Got some very nice jumps, a lot of good technique within his jumping. He gets up into the air, hits a good position on the jumps, and then has a nice flowing edge on the way out.
Variations to it, very difficult, up and down, knee movements.
know, it's interesting. It's got me thinking about this whole thing about Philippe Condoloro, how he performs and how Ermanov performs. Now, Ermanov truly is a better skater, at least the technique within his jumps, much stronger. But he doesn't connect with his audience, and Condoloro does connect with his audience. It seems as though it's a personality-driven sport, unlike basketball, football, or baseball. And that's what makes our sport so different, and it attracts different people to enjoy different skaters. And this is the triple axel that was so perfect in the air. Wonderful rotation. Look at the solid, controlled edge on the way out.
You really hear his landings. There's so much power on them. Such tight leg position in the air. Good control. Alexei Ermanov finished in fourth place after the short program. Let's take a look at the scores now for his interpretive free program.
They range from 5.3 up to 5.6. Rosalind mentioned, I think with more experience as a professional, we're going to see the character and the personality come out in this young man, and that will certainly improve.
And the second set of marks range from 5.4 to 5.7, easily enough to keep him ahead of Philippe Candeloro of France. On the ice now, Japanese champion getting a final word of encouragement from his coach, Doug Lee. Sixth in the world in 1999, here is Takeshi Honda. And you can see right there with that handshake from Doug, the friendship that they've developed. And that is so important when you're competing. You really need that behind you. It's just as important as a coach that pushes you. Skating to I Could Not Ask for More by Edwin McCain. Pick music for him that just brings out this whole new side of him, whole new strength, and he's going to need it here. Opening triple axel. Oh, just like butter.
Just like butter.
Just so great. He has a whole new ease about him this season.
And he also has command over a big jump, and here it is, the quad. Only a poor attempt at it that time. Timing didn't allow him to get up in the air and rotate that jump.
stage, Takeshi Honda of Japan. His improvement over the year has been dramatic. We'll see what the judges think after this.
We welcome you back to Tokyo, Japan, as Takeshi Honda waits for the marks from the judges.
Well, he may have missed the attempt at the quad, but here, a very, very easy triple axel. Everything else in the program just done with such care also. So much confidence on the landings.
And the triple loop, look at the arms. The perfect position they're in to really create that rotation right where they should be. Wrapped right around the chest.
And now here are the first set of marks, these four skating techniques for Takeshi Honda.
These are pretty decent marks from 5'4 to 5'6. I think the big thing about Takeshi is he's decided, yes, I do want to be a champion, and you're seeing that in his skating.
And now his presentation marks, 5.4 up to 5.6.
Again, a very different piece of music than you're going to see from the other men out here. But again, it showcases his talents and his personality, and that's what this interpretive free is all about.
Yeah, it went the wrong way. Completely wrong.
On the ice now from the United States, former world champion, five-time U.S. champion. Here is Todd Eldridge. After the short program, he's sitting in third place. His music is 13th Warrior.
And this is the program that's been so strong for him this season. And tonight, he's added the quad. It will be the first element in the program. He hasn't hit any of them in practice, but just for himself, he has to attempt it. He can't hold back. That's the first step.
Triple toe ollie. Not a quad, but still a great jump.
Gotta
remind everybody that this is the interpretive free program, and judges aren't looking at just the big jumps. They want to see, again, how the program works with the music and the choreography that's within that music.
It's important to point out that not only do his jumps get more consistent every year, but just the feeling he has on the ice is just so much part of him now. It's just down to the last, every little fingertip, the last move. It's clean, it's precise.
Strength.
give Todd Eldridge a competition in an audience, look what happens. He rises to the occasion.
...28-year-old Todd Eldridge of the United States once again lays down a spectacular performance.
And part of it was with this great triple axel, but again, the way he timed that to the music and to do it that far into the program, great stamina.
And these spins, the speed and the power at the end of the program, powerful ending with a position at the end that just says to the judges, here you go, take it. Well, remember that this is worth two-thirds of the total mark. If Todd wins the interpretive free, he wins it all. Here's his first set. These for skating techniques.
5-5. Definitely some room in there with 6.0 being the highest mark. Yagudin still to skate, but a very solid performance.
Second set of marks now for presentation. 5-6s up to 5-8 when we come back. The current leader and world champion, Alexei Yagudin of Russia. 5-7, 5-6. Japan, the men's interpretive free skate. Todd Eldridge, the leader right now, ahead of Takeshi Honda and Alexei Ermanov. But here is the leader after the short program, the final competitor in the men's event, two-time and current world champion, Alexei Yagudin.
This is a rework of the free program that he does in Olympic eligible skating. That is at the World Championship opening. Triple axel, turning out of that, not so good.
Position is to be on top. That's when everybody wants to overtake you. It's a lot of pressure.
Wow, it was amazing he pulled that jump off because he was really tilted, but his awareness allows him to land with a sure edge like that. Thank you.
rotation, really losing his focus on that triple lutz. That's a big setback for him.
Well, this has absolutely let the door open for Todd Eldridge. He took every advantage of that. Yagudin just looks very tired. Alexei Yagudin of Russia in first place after the short program. He was beaten by Todd Eldridge at the Masters Open competition. Was that enough, Peter, to hold Todd off here?
Well, I'd have to say definitely from my point of view, no, it's not, because he wasn't sharp the way he usually is, and he sort of dropped off towards the end of the program. So I'd have to give it to Eldridge on this occasion. And very solid here. Stepping right up into another jump. This is the triple loop, a backward right outside edge takeoff, but you could see him tilt and then pull the jump off due to the strength that he has. Great awareness there.
Well, he fought for that one, but of course he didn't even complete the triple lutz at all. And of course he stepped out of the triple axel, which Todd completed perfectly. So that's a huge difference. And now here are the marks for Alexei Yagudin. First set skating techniques. High marks, Peter. 5.55, 6 is 1.57.
Yes, they are high marks, and it's going to be close. The second mark will definitely tell the story. The presentation mark.
5.6. And now the second set. All 5.8.
Wow, surprising.
Wow, I felt the program was very tired. It lacked the spark that he usually has. I just don't feel it had the command that Todd Eldridge's program had.
Well, it had three first place marks, and that is enough to give the title to Alexei Yagudin of Russia. In second place, Todd Eldridge of the United States, Takeshi Honda of Japan in third, Alexei Armanov of Russia in fourth, Philippe Candeloro of France finishes fifth. Now let's go backstage and join Dee Lynam.
Alexei Yagudin, the winner here at the Japan Open, and we were talking about the end of the curse, because you said coming into this competition you have never skated well in Japan, and now you're victorious. So what does that say?
You know, it says something strange, because if this tradition to lose all the competitions in Japan is over, so something should happen in future, and I'm not sure about what. So I will be, I think, preparing for something.
Alexei, tell me, I know obviously you're happy with the result, but were you pleased with your performance? Were you pleased with the way you skated?
You know, I don't know what's going on with me, because I was pretty ready for this competition, and I know it's hard to skate in Japan, but I was ready, and then short program was excellent, and in interpretive program something happened to me, so I didn't skate pretty good, but I'm so happy with my result.
More happy for you. Thanks for taking the time.
Maybe.
In the first two open competitions this season, Todd Eldridge dominated the men's field. Tonight, he did not make it three in a row. He finished a strong second. Alexei Yagudin has lost some of his world championship form. He's showing signs he's human. The quad was not here with him in Japan, but his courage was. When we come back,